Each Monday I pick out the Northern Hemisphere's celestial highlights, mid-northern latitudes, for the week ahead. But be sure to check my main feed for more in-depth articles on stargazing, astronomy, eclipses and more. This week is all about the coming blue moon. Since it's the third of four full moons this summer season, it's technically termed a blue moon by astronomers, but as you'll see, it will turn from orange to yellow, not blue, as it rises into the night sky. This month there are two successive nights when you should look for the full blue moon rising. Your first opportunity comes tonight at dusk. Find a low easterly horizon and you'll see a blue moon appear draped in deep orange hues. Look about 4 degrees above and you'll see the bright planet Jupiter, with Saturn further to the southeast. Here's another chance to see, at dusk and in the east, the exquisite sight of a rising full moon. It will appear to be just about as full as yesterday night. Beginning at 8 a.m. Eastern Daylight Saving Time this morning is a spacewalk at the International Space Station, ISS, which will be screened live on NASA TV on YouTube. NASA astronaut Mark Vande and JAXA astronaut Akihiko Hoshide will spend 6.5 hours installing hardware to support more solar panels. SpaceX will today, at 3:37 a.m. Eastern Daylight Saving Time, launch a regular resupply mission to the ISS. A reusable Falcon 9 rocket will launch a Dragon cargo capsule from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. It will be SpaceX's 23rd such mission. Watch it on the SpaceX Live channel on YouTube. See the legendary Arcturus, the bright reddish star and the brightest star in the Northern Hemisphere's summer night sky, in the constellation of Boötes. Try the famous star hop. Begin from the curve of the handle of stars in the Big Dipper, Plough, Saucepan high above you, and go, arc to Arcturus. Watch the rising of the blue moon this week and you'll notice that, well, it's definitely not blue. As it rises in the east it will look orange, turning to a pale yellow as it rises higher into the sky, before appearing a bright, whitish-grey. Why? Rayleigh scattering. Earth's atmosphere contains oxygen and nitrogen molecules that absorb some wavelengths of light more effectively than others. Colors in the sun's light with short wavelengths, such as blue, strike more particles and are therefore more easily absorbed. They scatter more easily, which is why the sky is blue during the day. Colors with longer wavelengths, such orange, more easily pass through the atmosphere uninhibited. When you look at moonrise, you're looking across the planet, so you're looking through a lot of atmosphere. Rayleigh scattering is intensified, with orange dominating the light that makes it to your eyes. Wishing you clear skies and wide eyes.